Mohammed Al-Fayed, born Mohammed Fayed, the 27th of January 1929, is an Egyptian-born businessman whose residence and chief business interests have been in the United Kingdom since the late 1960s. Fayed's business interests include ownership of Hotel Ritz Paris and formerly Harrods Department Store and Fulham FC, both in London. Fayed famously had a son, Doddy, from his first marriage to Samira Khashoggi from 1954 to 1956. Doddy was in a romantic relationship with Diana, Princess of Wales, when they both died in a car crash in Paris in 1997. Fayed married Finnish socialite and former model Heini Wathen in 1985, with whom he also has four children, Jasmine, Karim, Camilla, and Omar. In 2013, Fayed's wealth was estimated at $1.4 billion, ranking his wealth at number 1,031 in the world. Chapter 1, Early Life. He was born Mohammed Fayed in Rushdie, Alexandria, Egypt, the eldest son of an Egyptian primary school teacher. Although he claims to have been born in 1933, records have showed he was actually born in 1929. Fayed has six sons and five siblings: Ali, Ashraf, Salah, Soed, and Sophia. Ali and Salah have been his business colleagues. He was married for 2 years, from 1954 to 1956, to Samira Khashoggi. Fayed worked with his wife's brother, Saudi Arabian arms dealer and businessman Adnan Khashoggi. Sometime in the early 1970s, he began using Al-Fayed rather than Fayed. His brothers Ali and Salah began to follow suit at the time of their acquisition of the House of Fraser in the 1980s, though by the late 1980s, both had reverted to calling themselves simply Fayed. Some have assumed that Fayed's addition of Al to his name was to imply aristocratic origins, like do in French or von in German, though Al does not have the same social connotations in Arabic. This assumption led to Private Eye magazine nicknaming him the phony Pharaoh. Chapter 2, United Kingdom. Chapter 2, Section 1, Early Business Dealings. Fayed and his brothers founded a shipping company in Egypt before moving its headquarters to Genoa, Italy, with offices in London. Around 1964, Fayed entered a close relationship with Haitian leader François Duvalier, known as Papa Doc, and became interested in the construction of a Fayed Duvalier oil refinery in Haiti. He also associated with the geologist Georges de Morinchilt. Fayed terminated his stay in Haiti 6 months later when a sample of crude oil provided by Haitian associates proved to be low-grade molasses. It was then that Fayed moved to England, where he lived in central London. In the mid-1960s, Fayed met the ruler of Dubai, Sheikh Rashid bin Saeed Al Maktoum, who entrusted Fayed with helping transform Dubai, where he set up IMS in 1968. Fayed introduced British companies like the Costain Group, Bernard Sunley and Sons and Taylor Woodrow to the Emirate to carry out the required construction work. He also became a financial advisor to the then Sultan of Brunei Omar Ali Saifuddin III. In 1966, he briefly joined the board of the mining conglomerate Lonro in 1975 but left after a disagreement. In 1979, Fayed bought the Ritz Hotel in Paris, France, for $30 million. In 1984, Fayed and his brothers purchased a 30% stake in House of Fraser, a group that included the famous London store Harrods, from Roland Tiny Roland, the head of Lonro. In 1985, he and his brothers bought the remaining 70% of House of Fraser for £615 million. Roland claimed the Fayed brothers lied about their background and wealth, and he put pressure on the government to investigate them. A Department of Trade and Industry inquiry into the Fayeds was launched. The DTI's subsequent report was critical, but no action was taken against the Fayeds, and while many believed the contents of the report, others felt it was politically motivated. In 1998, Roland accused Fayed of stealing papers and jewels from his Harrods safe deposit box. Fayed was arrested, but the charges were dropped. Roland died in 1998. Fayed settled the dispute with a payment to his widow. He also sued the Metropolitan Police for false arrest in 2002, but lost the case. In 1994, House of Fraser went public, but Fayed retained the private ownership of Harrods. He relaunched the humorous magazine Punch in 1996, but it folded again in 2002. Al-Fayed applied for British citizenship twice, once in 1994 and once in 1999, both unsuccessfully. It was suggested that the feud with Roland contributed to Fayed being refused British citizenship the first time. Chapter 2, Section 2, Cash for Questions. In 1994, in what became known as the Cash for Questions affair, Fayed revealed the names of MPs he had paid to ask questions in Parliament on his behalf, but who had failed to declare their fees. It saw the Conservative MPs Neil Hamilton and Tim Smith leave the government in disgrace, and a Committee on Standards in Public Life established to prevent such corruption occurring again. Fayed also revealed that the Cabinet Minister Jonathan Aitken had stayed for free at the Ritz Hotel in Paris at the same time as a group of Saudi arms dealers, leading to Aitken's subsequent unsuccessful libel case and imprisonment for perjury. During this period, from 1988 to February 1998, Al-Fayed's spokesman was Michael Cole, a former BBC journalist, although Cole's PR work for Al-Fayed did not cease in 1998. Hamilton lost a subsequent libel action against Al-Fayed in December 1999, and a subsequent appeal against the verdict in December 2000. The former MP has always denied that he was paid by Al-Fayed for asking questions in Parliament. Hamilton's libel action related to a Channel 4 Dispatches documentary broadcast on 16 January 1997 in which Al-Fayed made claims that the MP had received up to £110,000 in cash and received other gratuities for asking parliamentary questions. Hamilton's basis for his appeal was that the original verdict was invalid because Al-Fayed had paid £10,000 for documents stolen from the dustbins of Hamilton's legal representatives by Benjamin Pell. In 2003, Fayed moved from Surrey, UK to Switzerland, alleging a breach in an agreement with the British Tax Authority. In 2005, he moved back to Britain, saying that he regards Britain as home. He bought a yacht called the Sakaar in Monaco prior to selling it in 2014. Chapter 2, Section 3, Sale of Harrods. After denials that Harrods was for sale, it was sold to Qatar Holdings, the sovereign wealth fund of the country of Qatar, on 10 May 2010. A fortnight previously, Fayed had stated that people approach us from Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, Qatar. Fair enough. But I put two fingers up to them. It is not for sale. This is not Marks and Spencer or Sainsbury's. It is a special place that gives people pleasure. There is only one Mecca. Harrods was sold for £1.5 billion. Fayed later revealed in an interview that he decided to sell Harrods following the difficulty in getting his dividend approved by the trustee of the Harrods Pension Fund. Fayed said, "I'm here every day, I can't take my profit because I have to take a permission of those bloody idiots. I say, is this right? Is this logic? Somebody like me. I run a business and I need to take bloody fucking trustees' permission to take my profit." Fayed was appointed honorary chairman of Harrods, a position he was scheduled to hold for at least 6 months. Chapter 2, Section 4, Scotland Real Estate. In 1972, Fayed purchased the Balnagown Estate in Easter Ross, northern Scotland. From an initial 4.8 hectares, Al-Fayed has since built the estate up to 26,300 hectares. Al-Fayed has invested more than £20 million in the estate, restored the 14th century pink Balnagown Castle, and created a tourist accommodation business. The Highlands of Scotland Tourist Board awarded Al-Fayed the Freedom of the Highlands in 2002, in recognition of his outstanding contribution and commitment to the Highlands. As an Egyptian with links to Scotland, Al-Fayed was intrigued enough to fund a 2008 reprint of the 15th century chronicle Scoticronicon by Walter Bauer. The Scoticronicon describes how Scota, a sister of the Egyptian pharaoh Tutankhamun, fled her family and landed in Scotland, bringing with her the Stone of Scone. According to the Chronicle, Scotland was later named in her honour. The tale is disputed by modern historians. Al-Fayed later declared that the Scots are originally Egyptians and that's the truth. In 2009, Al-Fayed revealed that he was a supporter of Scottish independence from the United Kingdom, announcing to the Scots that it's time for you to waken up and detach yourselves from the English and their terrible politicians. Whatever help is needed for Scotland to regain its independence, I will provide it. When you Scots regain your freedom, I am ready to be your president. Chapter 2, Section 5, Charity. Fayed set up the Al-Fayed Charitable Foundation in 1987 aiming to help children with life-limiting conditions and children living in poverty. The charity works mainly with charities and hospices for disabled and neglected children in the UK, Thailand and Mongolia. Some of the charities with which it works include Francis House Hospice in Manchester, Great Ormond Street Hospital and Childline. In 1998, Al-Fayed bought Princess Diana's old boarding school in Kent and helped found the new school at West Heath for children with additional needs and mental health problems. In 2011, Mohammed Al-Fayed's daughter Camilla, who has worked as an ambassador for the charity for 8 years, opened the newly refurbished Zoe's Place Baby Hospice in West Derby, Liverpool. Chapter 2, Section 6, Fulham FC. Al-Fayed bought West London professional football club, Fulham FC, for £6.25 million in 1997. The purchase was made via Bill Muddiman's Muddiman Group. His long-term aim was that Fulham would become a Premier League side within 5 years. In 2001, Fulham took the first division under manager Jean Tigana, winning 100 points and scoring over 100 goals in the season. This meant that Al-Fayed had achieved his Premier League aim a year ahead of schedule. By 2002, Fulham were competing in European football, winning the Intertoto Cup and challenging in the UEFA Cup. Fulham reached the final of the 2009-10 UEFA Europa League and continued to play in the Premier League throughout Al-Fayed's tenure as owner, which ended in 2013. Fulham temporarily left Craven Cottage while it was being upgraded to meet modern safety standards. There were fears that the club would not return to the cottage after it was revealed that Al-Fayed had sold the first right to build on the ground to a property development firm. Fulham lost a legal case against former manager Tigana in 2004 after Al-Fayed had wrongly alleged that Tigana had overpaid more than £7 million for new players and had negotiated transfers in secret. In 2009, Al-Fayed said that he was in favour of a wage cap for footballers, and criticised the management of the Football Association and Premier League as run by donkeys who don't understand business, who are dazzled by money. A statue of the American entertainer Michael Jackson was unveiled by Al-Fayed in April 2011 at Craven Cottage. In 1999, Jackson had attended a league game against Wigan Athletic at the stadium. Following criticism of the statue, Al-Fayed said if some stupid fans don't understand and appreciate such a gift this guy gave to the world, they can go to hell. I don't want them to be fans. The statue was taken down by the club's new owners in 2013. Al-Fayed blamed the club's subsequent relegation from the Premier League on the bad luck brought by its removal. Al-Fayed then donated the statue to the National Football Museum. In March 2019, the statue was removed from the museum due to the backlash against Jackson caused by the accusations against him in the documentary Leaving Neverland. Under Al-Fayed, Fulham FC was owned by Mafco Holdings, based in the tax haven of Bermuda, and in turn owned by Al-Fayed and his family. By 2011, Al-Fayed had lent Fulham FC £187 million in interest-free loans. In July 2013, it was announced that Al-Fayed had sold the club to Pakistani-American businessman Shahid Khan, who owns the NFL's Jacksonville Jaguars. Chapter 3, Business Interests. Al-Fayed's business interests include Hotel Ritz Paris, Balnagoan Castle and Estates, Scottish Highlands, HJW Geospatial, Turnbull and Asser, 75 Rockefeller Plaza, New York City, built in 1947, originally the Esso Building, later the Time Warner Building, is owned by Al-Fayed and managed and leased by RXR Realty. Al-Fayed's major business purchases have included Ritz Hotel Paris, House of Fraser Group, including Harrods, Fulham Football Club. After the death of Wallace Simpson, Fayed took over the lease of the Villa Windsor in Paris, the former home of the Duchess of Windsor and her husband, the Duke of Windsor, previously Edward VIII. Chapter 4, Death of Dodi Fayed. Chapter 4, Section 1, Background and Relationship with Diana. Lady Diana Spencer was born in 1961, and married the heir to the British throne, Charles, Prince of Wales, in 1981, becoming the Princess of Wales. Diana was an international celebrity and a frequent visitor to Harrods in the 1980s. Al-Fayed and Dodi first met Diana and Charles when they were introduced at a polo tournament in July 1986, that had been sponsored by Harrods. Diana and Charles divorced in 1996. Diana was hosted by Al-Fayed in the south of France in mid-1997, with her sons, Princes William and Harry. For the holiday, Fayed bought a 195-foot yacht, the Jonical. Dodi and Diana later began a private cruise on the Jonical, and paparazzi photographs of the couple in an embrace were published. Diana's friend, the journalist Richard Kay, confirmed that Diana was involved in her first serious romance since her divorce. Dodi and Diana went on a second private cruise on the Jonical in the third week of August, and returned from Sardinia to Paris on the 30th of August. The couple privately dined at the Ritz later that day, after the behavior of the press caused them to cancel a restaurant reservation. They then planned to spend the night at Dodi's apartment near the Arc de Triomphe. In an attempt to deceive the paparazzi, a decoy car left the front of the hotel, while Diana and Dodi departed at speed in a Mercedes-Benz S280 driven by chauffeur Henri Paul from the rear of the hotel. 5 minutes later, the car crashed in the Pont de l'Alma tunnel. Dodi and Paul died on the spot. Diana died afterwards in hospital. Fayed arrived in Paris a day later and viewed Dodi's body, which was finally returned to the United Kingdom for an Islamic funeral. Chapter 4, Section 2, Conspiracy Theories. From February 1998, Al-Fayed maintained that the crash was a result of a conspiracy, and later contended that the crash was orchestrated by MI6 on the instructions of Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh. His claims that the crash was a result of a conspiracy were dismissed by a French judicial investigation, but Fayed appealed against this verdict. A libel action was brought against Al-Fayed by Neil Hamilton. The British Operation Paget, a Metropolitan Police inquiry that concluded in 2006, also found no evidence of a conspiracy. To Operation Paget, Al-Fayed made 175 conspiracy claims. An inquest headed by Lord Justice Scott Baker into the deaths of Diana and Dodi began at the Royal Courts of Justice, London, on the 2nd of October 2007 and lasted for 6 months. It was a continuation of the original inquest that had begun in 2004. At the Scott Baker inquest, Fayed accused the Duke of Edinburgh, the Prince of Wales, Lady Sarah McCorkadale, her sister, and numerous others, of plotting to kill the Princess of Wales. Their motive, he claimed, was that they could not tolerate the idea of the princess marrying a Muslim. Al-Fayed first claimed that the princess was pregnant to the Daily Express in May 2001, and that he was the only person who had been told of this news. Witnesses at the inquest who said the princess was not pregnant, and could not have been, were part of the conspiracy, according to Al-Fayed. Fayed's testimony at the inquest was roundly condemned in the press as being farcical. Members of the British government's Intelligence and Security Committee accused Fayed of turning the inquest into a circus and called for it to be ended maturely. Lawyers representing Al-Fayed later accepted at the inquest that there was no direct evidence that either the Duke of Edinburgh or MI6 had been involved in any murder conspiracy involving Diana or Dodi. A few days before Al-Fayed's appearance, John McNamara, a former senior detective at Scotland Yard and Al-Fayed's investigator for 5 years from 1997, was forced to admit on the 14th of February 2008 that he had no evidence to suggest foul play, except for the assertions Al-Fayed had made to him. His admissions also related to the lack of evidence for Al-Fayed's claims about the alleged pregnancy of the princess and the couple's supposed engagement. The jury verdict, given on the 7th of April 2008, was that Diana and Doddy had been unlawfully killed through the grossly negligent driving of chauffeur Henri Paul, who was intoxicated, and the pursuing vehicles. Lawyers for Al-Fayed also accepted that there was no evidence to support the assertion that Diana was illegally embalmed in order to cover up a pregnancy that they accepted could not be established by any medical evidence. They also accepted that there was no evidence to support the assertion the French emergency and medical services had played any role in a conspiracy to harm Diana. Following the Baker inquest, Al-Fayed said that he was abandoning his campaign to prove that Diana and Doddy were murdered in a conspiracy, and said that he would accept the verdict of the jury. Al-Fayed financially supported Unlawful Killing, a documentary film presenting his version of events. The film was not formally released as a result of legal problems. Chapter 5, Sexual Harassment Allegations. Al-Fayed has been accused by multiple women of sexual harassment and assault. Young women applying for employment at Harrods were often submitted to HIV tests and gynecological examinations. These women were then selected to spend the weekend with Al-Fayed in Paris. In her profile of Al-Fayed for Vanity Fair, Maureen Orth described how, according to former employees, Fayed regularly walked the store on the lookout for young, attractive women to work in his office. Those who rebuffed him would often be subjected to crude, humiliating comments about their appearance or dress. A dozen ex-employees I spoke with said that Fayed would chase secretaries around the office and sometimes try to stuff money down women's blouses. In 1994, Herminia de Silva quit her job as a nanny at Al-Fayed's home in Oxford. Silva had prepared accusations that she was sexually harassed by Al-Fayed, and she was subsequently arrested by detectives and held overnight in cells following a complaint of theft by an employee of Al-Fayed's. She was later released without charge after officers concluded she had not stolen anything. Al-Fayed eventually settled with her out of court, and she was awarded £12,000. Al-Fayed was interviewed under caution by the Metropolitan Police after an allegation of sexual assault against a 15-year-old schoolgirl in October 2008. The case was dropped by the Crown Prosecution Service after they found that there was no realistic chance of conviction due to conflicting statements. In December 1997, the ITV Current Affairs programme, The Big Story, broadcast testimonies from a number of former Harrods employees who spoke of how women were routinely sexually harassed by Al-Fayed. A December 2017 episode of Channel 4's Dispatches program alleged that Al-Fayed had sexually harassed three Harrods employees and attempted to groom them. One of the women was aged 17 at the time. Cheska Hillwood waived her right to anonymity to be interviewed for the program. The program alleged Al-Fayed targeted young employees over a 13-year period.